So we are in Institute of Oncology, so we not only treat the patient, but we hope to provide some decent research. And we hope that collaboration with industry will enable us to conduct really interesting research.
Medical imaging started when people started wanting to look into the insides, and the first way we could do that was x-rays. And for a long while, x-rays were pretty much the only medical images up until around the 1950s, when we started using radioactive materials, so you could inject a radioactive material and see where that goes. Rather than looking at the structures within the body, we're actually starting to look at the function and what's going on inside the body. And then with the digital revolution in the 80s and the introduction of DICOM, which is a format that allows exchange of images between different systems, we're able to start processing those images and trying to extract extra information. And really, that's brought us to today when we have these amazing MR scanners and CT scanners that can produce fantastic images of people's insides. And when we look at an image, we see what the eye has learned to see. So we're looking at the changes that our eye developed to detect. We find shapes, we find structures, and our radiologists go through a decade of training. And their eye is trained to spot structures, but there are things the eye can't see very easily, subtle changes, changes over time and so on. And we have difficulty quantifying changes in contrast and so on. The eye picks out those contrasts, but we're not very good at saying that change is greater than another change and so on. So the limitation is really in producing a value that can be compared. If you have two radiologists looking at a tumour and saying whether it's heterogeneous, they will be able to give an opinion, but it's very difficult for them to quantify that. And software is essential to modern medical imaging. It is about the software.
In the ECONI project, we'll be looking at the temporal changes in attenuation in vessels and tissues in a series of images acquired after injecting a contrast medium into the patient's body. We hope we'll be able to extract new biomarkers and to boost the performance of the currently used DC markers, just to make sure that every single bit of information about the patient condition is properly exploited. Those biomarkers can be used to quantify the tumor characteristics and stage, as well as for stratifying the risks for patients with cancer. To make this possible, we need to tackle at least three kinds of challenges. First, we have the scientific challenges, which appear at every single step of the processing pipeline in the system, starting from the accurate image segmentation towards the advanced analysis of the DCE maps. Then we have the technical challenges, because we want to provide the software which will be actually used in a day-to-day clinical practice. And finally, we need to make sure that the project is well managed, which is not trivial in a regulated environment. The team has been working together for the last 10 years on a number of various medical imaging projects. We believe that our background and experience in bringing the research results into the industry will allow for providing software which will actually make a huge difference in a personalized medical care.
This equipment in this room looks like a CT, so computed tomography, but this is not CT. This is a tomotherapy, so we use it for the irradiation of patients. And radiotherapy has changed dramatically during the last years, and everything was because of the computers. So everything is about imaging this time, because we first prepare special equipment to immobilize patient, then we do CT. And using this CT, we create patient's model, and this model is used then for optimizing the radiation therapy. So in order to prepare the plan, first we have to see the tumor. And it's not always very easy. To see the tumor, we must prepare special imaging, and this imaging is done with different methods. And some of methods are quite different from the normal CT. So we have some time somehow to join these different images, and we do it with special registration and then with special image fusion. So I think that in the future I hope we will have the possibility to draw the target, because the humans are better in joining different data, but computers are best in very precise distinguishing between the normal tissue and tissue that is changed by the cancer. So I hope that the human interaction with the process of tumor diagnosis and treatment will be minimized to interaction between the patient and the doctor.